Children, today we are going to start our first lesson. What is your first lesson, children? The animal kingdom. The animal kingdom. Children, you have learned about different animals, isn't it? Yes. You know that birds and insects are also animals. Do you know that we human beings are also animals? Yes. And observe the animals that you see around you. And will you identify the similarities that you find between animals and yourself? Yes. Let us see few differences and similarities between human beings and animals. So first we'll see similarities. They eat and sleep, human beings. Animals also eat and sleep. Human beings have two ears and two eyes. Animals also two ears and two eyes. Human beings have thinking capacity. Animals also have thinking capacity. Yes. Now difference. Human beings do not have tail. Yes or no, children? Yes. Human beings do not have tail. Animals have tail. Human beings have two legs. Animals have four legs. Human beings do not have horns. Animals have horns. If you see buffalo, goat, ox and all means, you can see the horns. Yes, no, children? So, these are examples for the similarities and differences between the human beings and animals. So, now we will see some different kinds of animals based on food habits. What are those? Herbivorous, carnivorous, omnivorous. So first one is herbivorous. So animals which eat the product of plants such as grass and leaf etc. are called herbivorous. So children, these herbivorous animals eat only the product of plants. Okay, for example, cow, zebra, elephant, deer, horse etc. So next type of animals are carnivorous. So animals which eat flesh, egg and other products of animals are called carnivorous. For example, tiger, leopard, wolf, snow leopard, polar bear, crocodile, shark etc. These carnivorous animals eat other animals, egg, other products of animals. Okay, next type of animals are omnivorous. Animals which eat products of both plants and animals are called omnivorous. So these omnivorous animals will eat both plants. Not only plants, not only animals. Both plants and animals they will eat. For example, human beings. Why? Because even we, the people, will eat plant products and animal products. Both, right? Animals' flesh also. So, for example, human beings, chimpanzee, dog, rat, squirrel and brown bear, etc. So, next children, now we came to know different types of animals like omnivorous, carnivorous, herbivorous. So, it's based on their food, isn't it? Yes. So, what are the sources of food? Yes, exactly, the sources of food are plants and animals. From where we will get the food? Yes, from plants and animals. So plants and animals are the two main sources of food. So first we will see plants. So in plants, how we will eat it as a food? Yes, as a vegetable, as a fruit, as a grains, as a pulses, as green leafy vegetables etc. So in animals, how we will eat the food? As milk products such as cheese, paneer, ghee, buttermilk, butter, ice cream, lassi, honey, meat, eggs etc. Yes, no? So plants and animals are the two main sources of the food. Now we will see uses of animals to us. So how the animals will helps to human beings. So first we'll see ox. How the ox helps us? Pluffing helps in agriculture. Cow, it gives milk. Sheep, it gives wool. Parrot, we will keep it as pet animal for our entertainment and for companionship. Horse, we will use it as a horse carriage, like jatka. Yes, no? Honey bee, will use honey from honey bee. Fish, eating insects in water and keeping the water clean. Dog guards the house, isn't it? Yes. Children, I hope you understood this, the animal kingdom lesson. Yes or no? Okay. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the group also. You can put question also. So now the time for homework. Write 3 similarities between humans and animals. The same question, it will be there in your textbook also, children. In the page number 1, you have to write in the textbook. Second one, write 3 differences between humans and animals. This one also, you have to write in the textbook only, page number 2. Third question also, do this activity, page number 2. This main also, you have to do in the textbook only. Name of the animal, size, color, food, house. One example I will say. First one is cow. So in the size, you need to write how the cow size will be. It will be big only. Yes, no? So you have to write in the size column big. Color, so many colors are there. Sometimes it will be white, black, brown. So anyone you can write. Food, what is the food of cow? Plants, grass, anything. Because it's a herbivorous, right? House, what is the house name of cow? Shed. As like rest of the animals also you have to write, but these 3 means you should write in the textbook. I mentioned page number also, children. Okay, right. Afterwards, later on I will send the notes of this lesson that you have to copy in the EVS classwork.